Hello everyone! Today in the video we are going to create a cute frying pan with fried eggs. To support the video, don't forget to subscribe and like this video if you like my tutorials. Let's get started. Add circle. In the bottom left menu, I will set 8 vertices. In edit mode, on the Z axis, let's extrude the faces. Add 2 cuts at the top and bottom. And cut in the middle. Select the bottom loop. Close it with fill. Add subdivision surface modifier to the object. I will choose 3 levels. Select the bottom edge and narrow it a bit. Select the middle loop and make it larger. Select the upper edge and enlarge it a little bit too. I will decrease the bottom loop and the one above it. And add thickness by using the solidify modifier. Move the modifier to the top. Specify a thickness of 0.15 hundredths of a meter. Apply this modifier. Smooth the object. Let's decrease the height of the frying pan. Add plane. Narrow it. Move the future handle for the frying pan in its place. Add cuts. Shape the thickness of the handle. Let's narrow this loop. Move this one and resize it. This one we just move. Select the loop where it attaches to the frying pan and shrink it. Add subdivision surface modifier. I will add 4 levels. Add another cut and shift it. And another cut here. Add another cut at the end of the handle. Select the point and add a bevel. Let's make the future hole a more regular shape. Remove the faces. Select all. Extrude the thickness of the handle. Add a cut in the hole. And another one. Let's add a cut in the middle of the handle. Move the handle up under the middle of the frying pan. Smooth the handle. Hide the frying pan and the handle. Now create a scrambled egg. Let's add a cube. Add the subdivision surface modifier. Specify 4 levels. In editing mode, I will flatten the ball. Press the edge inward. Move it up to get a yolk. Add a cut at the bottom. Flatten the egg yolk. Change the shape of the egg so it is less symmetrical. Smooth the egg. Let's return the visibility of the frying pan. Reduce the size of the egg. Now let's add a background for the future render. In edit mode, we extrude the wall. Add the bevel modifier. I will set 10 segments. Smooth the background. Go to the shading tab. Select the frying pan. Add a material to it. Let's choose a base color. In edit mode, turn on the preview of the modifier. Select the inside of the frying pan. Add a new material. And press Assign. Specify the color of the inside of the frying pan so that a white scrambled egg is visible. Select the scrambled egg. Add a material to it. Decrease roughness. In edit mode, select the yolk. Add material to it and click Assign. Choose a base color. Change its roughness. Now we select the handle of the frying pan. Add material to it and choose a color. Select the background and add material too. Choose a delicate color. Go into viewport shading render. In the scene setup, we select the cycles render type. In the device, select GPU compute. In render, I will put 512 max samples. In the world tab, select color environment texture. Now I will load my favorite background. Add lighting, sun. Back to the layout tab. In the transformation, we set the rotation to 10 degrees on the x-axis. And 35 degrees on the y-axis. Add a camera. Select the perspective in the viewport. Press Ctrl plus Alt and Numpad 0 for the camera to apply the perspective. Now change the camera angle so that we like it. Press Render, render image. Remember to save the image to your PC when the render is complete. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please like it and subscribe to be the first to get new videos.